there's a little bit of a race in quantum computing. Who's going to get there first?
They already have a quantum computer that is available.
Speculative investors flocked to quantum computing late last year, but the sector took a dive when the future of commercialization seemed to be too far off. Now, a new nod from NVIDIA CEO has many investors hoping the sector could take off sooner rather than later, and it has other major competitors joining the quantum race.
Just because a company isn't a startup and isn't a pure play doesn't mean that they're not going to have a significant impact in this space.
Join us as MarketBeat analyst Chris Markoch shares his 7 quantum computing stock picks that could catapult your portfolio. Let's dive in. So Chris, quantum computing was all the rage at the end of last year and early this year when the whole industry saw quite the surge, but then it saw quite a bit of a dip. Let's just talk about what's happening kind of across this whole sector.
There's a lot of excitement about quantum computing, and that excitement is legitimate. There's been significant advances happening over the past 6 months, and it got a lot of investors out ahead of their skis a little bit in terms of when we were actually going to start seeing this technology be something that would be introduced at scale. And some remarks from Jensen Huang last week suggested that quantum computing may be a little closer than we think from a institutional side in terms of research, but it's still quite a ways away from being something that you and I might be using on a daily basis or in any sort of practical way.
So the advancements are coming faster than we thought, but it might not be something consumers see. It's a great point to make for investors to think about as they think about investing in quantum computing. But I think even though the sector saw a bit of a dip in the last couple of months, investors are still excited about the potential future of this sector really taking off. And that's why Chris has put together a list of 7 stocks set to have some great success in the quantum computing realm. So Chris, let's start off with your first pick.
Well, the first one is D-Wave Quantum. The ticker symbol is QBTS. The company is known for their quantum annealing technology. Most investors, if they've been investing in this space, will be familiar with D-Wave because they just had the announcement in the last week or so that one of their computers was able to achieve quantum supremacy in terms of how quickly it was able to calculate a problem compared to the fastest supercomputers that we have out there today. The stock also has been jumping recently because of the company's earnings, which happened on March 13th, and they beat on revenue, miss on earnings, but the company's not profitable yet, and investors tend to understand that. But the beat on revenue, that's what's got investors excited right now. And with a stock like this that's trading still around $10 a share, any sort of significant price movement in one way or the other is going to seem like a big move in the stock.
Yeah, there was quite a bit of movement in D-Wave over the last week or so. And I think that's because there's a little bit of a race in quantum computing of who's going to get there first.
Correct.
Is D-Wave the leader in that race right now?
I think so. When you look at it and say they already have a quantum computer that is available, but again, it's something that like one quantum computer might cost $10,000. They're not necessarily ready to produce this at scale, but it is something that is out there currently.
All right. Well, let's move on to your second pick, Chris.
The second pick is IONQ, and the ticker symbol there is IONQ. This is another pure play in the quantum computing space. One of the interesting things about IONQ is that they're looking to develop quantum computing that can be done at room temperature. And that's a key distinction because the energy that these quantum computers require also require that they operate at sub-zero temperatures. And that can be an obstacle in terms of, again, trying to get this technology produced at scale. That makes them an interesting play in the sector. However, you know, right now, they've kind of fallen back a little bit after what you were talking about, that late 2024 rush. They haven't quite rebounded yet, but you know, again, in the last few days, they've been picking up a little bit, and they're trying to find a little bit of support. It is fair to note that their stock's already trading up around $25 a share. So So there might be something here.
All right. Very good, Chris. Let's move on to your third pick in this industry that, again, like you said, is starting to take off again with investors reigniting their interest in quantum computing.
So yeah, the next pick is a company called Quantum Computing, and the ticker symbol is QUBT. This is another company that's trying, like what IONQ is doing, they're trying to develop quantum computers that can run at room temperatures. But where they're trying to carve out a niche is to create portable quantum computers. So these computers can operate with lower power needs. So not only can they operate at room temperature, but also because they're portable, they'll have lower power needs that way. And again, we're talking about a company that it's a very small company, a market cap of only around $700 million. It's trading for around $5, which puts it loosely in that penny stock category. It's not profitable. It generates very little revenue. But again, if you're looking for stocks that can have outside gains in this sector over the next few years, it's one that you might want to watch.
There are several companies in this sector that are still kind of in that penny stock range. Is that really because this whole industry is kind of in its infancy? You're getting in as an investor before anything really takes off at any level of scale or commercialization.
That's exactly it, Bridget. I mean, investors, especially investors who have some money to speculate with, are always looking for that next new thing because that's where the biggest gains are made. And investors are very familiar with the stories of companies like Amazon and Apple. And if you bought them then, and when they were back in the late 90s and early 2000s, you've made a significant profit, but you had to have the conviction to get in on those stocks early. We're seeing that a little bit with people that got involved with NVIDIA like 5 or 10 years ago, people that maybe got involved with Palantir 2 or 3 years ago. And so, but investors are always saying, okay, maybe those stocks are already past their peak. What's the next big thing? And quantum computing is one thing that they're looking at in that regard.
Yeah, absolutely. That's why sector-wide, you're seeing more interest right now.
Right.
But if you don't want to pick just one specific company, I think your next pick in this list of 7 stocks in quantum computing is going to be of interest for investors.
Right. And so we're talking about an ETF. In this case, we're talking about the ARK Next Generation Internet ETF. The ticker symbol is ARKW. One thing that investors really need to be understand about this is that they're getting exposure to the broader technology sector, not just the quantum computing space. Yes, they do get access to some companies that are involved in quantum computing, but this is more of a broad-based exposure to the entire technology sector. That may not be what some investors are looking for, but right now it's getting hard to find ETFs that are specifically drilling down to just quantum computing. And that's just because so many of the companies out there are these pure play companies that aren't profitable yet. And so a lot of institutional investors are staying away from them.
Yeah, the institutions tend to be really slow on buying into these speculative sectors. But for investors, there is still some strong potential out there, especially if you have some speculative cash to work with. If you are one of those growth investors, check out this free premium report on MarketBeat.com. It has 7 stocks that are poised to be magnificent in 2025. You can scan the QR code or click the link in the description of this video to get that free report on MarketBeat.com right now. If you are not into speculative buys, there's still a way to invest in quantum computing that's a little safer. Chris, and that really is what the rest of your list looks like.
The last 3 companies in this list are more of what you would call your blue chips. And that may be a very comfortable way for investors to get involved in quantum computing. Just because a company isn't a startup and isn't a pure play doesn't mean that they're not going to have a significant impact in this space. In fact, you may see some of these large cap companies either through acquisition or through some sort of partnership, be the companies that actually are the big names in the quantum computing space. And the first one we're going to look at is IBM, which may surprise some investors. But the one thing about IBM is they've been kind of working in the dark on quantum computing for a long time. And investors who have stuck with IBM over the years understand that that transition's been taking place. Well, now the company, after having developed this series of quantum computing processors, they're now kind of having their moment where they're saying, "Hey, we've been here all along, and we can provide hardware and software for this sector. And that could be an interesting way for investors to look at getting involved with the sector.
Yeah, IBM is a stock not many investors have thought about recently. The next pick on your list is one many investors may already have in their portfolio.
So that one is Microsoft. And of course, you know, everybody understands Microsoft's position in so many things in the technology sector, but they are trying to get dominance in what's the quantum chip race. Now, this past week, Jensen Huang talked about NVIDIA and how they're introducing their own version of a quantum chip. Well, in February of this year, Microsoft introduced what they called their Majorna 1 quantum chip, which is the first one to be specifically for quantum computing. So Microsoft kind of got ahead of NVIDIA there. Now the question is just going to be to see which of these chips may wind up capturing the most market share as we go forward.
That could be another reason to add more Microsoft if you want to right now. And there's a little bit of a dip in the company right now too.
Actually, it's not a bad time to look at Microsoft because Microsoft's been down this year and it's well off of its all-time high, but it's really looking attractive right now at the levels it's at. And right now, compared to the consensus targets of analysts, you've got about a 31% upside on the stock. It's a really good time to be looking at Microsoft.
Well, let's move on to your last pick in this list of seven computing stocks.
Right. So the last company is Alphabet. This is another one, another of the Mag 7. This is another stock that has been kind of beaten down a lot. It's trading down around $160 a share as we tape this, Bridget. And it's probably got about another 25-30% according to where the consensus of the analysts are. Where Alphabet fits in with the entire quantum computing space is they're designing their own quantum computing chip, just like Microsoft is, and it's called Willow. What Alphabet is saying is that their Willow chip addresses a key concern that quantum computers have right now, and that is that they have a high propensity to commit errors. They can calculate things quickly, but sometimes they don't always come up with the right answers. So according to Alphabet, Willow fixes this problem by operating, as they call it, below threshold, which means it can exponentially reduce errors as it scales using more qubits. That's a technical thing for some people who might understand the sector, but it's important to understand that if you're going to be getting involved in the sector, because those are the little things, those are the little advantages that one company may be providing over another, and it may be the reason why you want to own Alphabet stock.
Very interesting. I love this list, Chris, because it gives you some more solid and steady choices that might be the safer bet if you want to invest in this area, and also some of those more speculative buys if you really do believe in the future of quantum computing. Thank you for breaking down this list today, Chris. And if you want to learn more about other quantum computing lists, we talked about several other stocks when the sector was really exploding earlier this year and late last year. We've linked some of those here for you to watch too. Thanks again for joining us, everyone. And as always, happy investing.